Fields with, oh, the first run of the day.
Away from the Keebra Park line, Ezekiel Evans will run into Lee Harris, hit by Herman Retzlaff.
Ah, shot.
A Hermanator.
Shot.
To come up left with Payne. Helmet up and then a huge tackle.
He gets it. Oh! Welcome to Suncorp, Jeff Moses on McCallum.
He's picked up and driven.
And here we are, we're the princes of the universe. Here we belong, fighting for survival.
Was there a Hilton? For your drugs. Oh, you are. That's mine. That's pretty.
Hey guys, welcome back to YouTube's Cliches. We're here, Langlands Park. Let's go.
KBC.
KFC.
KFC.
Yo.
Hey.
Hey,
hey
bro.
No, actually, let's go.
Great. Yeah, we're here with Woody.
How do you feel? We're about 10 minutes from an hour and 10 minutes since the game. How you feel?
What?
We're about an hour and 10 before the game.
Oh, yeah.
How you
mate,
feeling?
Mate, I'm feeling good.
Feeling good?
Getting the mind in the right spot.
Getting the mind in the right spot.
Just preparing mentally. And I'm keen.
Okay.
It's a main thing, you know.
Yeah. I'm here with Lockie, mate. Hour and 8 minutes actually to the game now. How do you feel?
Yeah, feeling keen, mate. Excited. The boys have prepared well.
I'm here with the Herman Ball, Wrecking Ball.
Is that Milwaukee?
Oh. Yeah.
Hey guys, how's it going?
Full runner now, 44. Level time, 8.
Trey, how do you feel? About 2 hours into the ball kickoff. How do you feel, mate?
The camera's
so here with an old boy. Here at Keebra.
Today we have Seth Livingston. Lachlan West. Lockie Adamson. Blake Bloody Moser. Knees, KFC.
Best bar receiving the league.
Julio.
Julio? He said Julio.
No. He said me.
Me.
Go. Come back with shirts. About to get strapped. Bring you back in second.
Alright.
Hello.
Bet. How are you all? What are your thoughts of the pre-game?
Pretty good. We are preparing well. Yeah.
Look, Wes, passing the ball pre-game. How do you feel about today's game?
Good. Buddy.
Good, buddy?
Yeah, buddy.
Connor Takani here.
On the front door, announced the side of our meeting beforehand, right? So we're going against the numbers of last week. The only change is Drake will go to 18 bandwidth.
We're about 2-3 minutes away, so get ready. Make sure you've got everything ready to warm up. We'll head out to the coach.
Don't feel me while I'm being stressed. Now look, this is the way I'm looking at it. I'm playing darts a week, and in the dartboard games we've won every week. I have 4 throws for each quarter of the game, even though it's not very difficult. So I throw, if I get over 40, we win that quarter. So I go, we won the first one, won the second one, and they came back, and we won the other two, so we should be right. I think of things like, ooh, is that bloke there? That's 80 boys from this one. Oh, he's there. Is 80 Savage there? Oh, he's not there. Ooh. I can't sleep at night. So. But after this, I'll be feeling good. It'll be KFC all round.
Occasion here at Totally Workwear Stadium today as we welcome you to the first ever Alan Langer Trophy Grand Final in its 20th edition. Palm Beach Currumbin up against Keebra Park. Of course, this is the first ever season that we've had a Grand Final. And what a spectacle we have. Two great rivals. There's nothing much separating them. Let's have a look how they both line up this afternoon for the 2020 Alan Langer Trophy Grand Final. We'll start with Palm Beach Currumbin, the defending champions, going for three in a row this afternoon. De Groot at fullback, Roberts and Duckett on the wings, Somerville and Mariner in the centres, Rivett and Weaver are the halves, Russell's the lock forward, Butterini and Priestley in the back row, Willison the captain alongside Jack Cullen in the front row, Uta Bergen is the hooker. On the bench, Oscar Bryant, Bailey Martin, Caden Somerville, Ryan Foran, and also Parker Bryant. They're coached by Jim Francis. They are the defending champions, Palm Beach Currumbin. But standing in their way this afternoon are Keebra Park, who are the only side to have won three in a row, something Palm Beach Currumbin are going for today. Let's have a look at Keebra's lineup. Khan Pereira at fullback. Levi Jones, the competition's leading try scorer, on one wing alongside captain Trey Penny on the other wing. Buller and Cleese Haas in the centres. Talia and Takani in the halves. Gun James is the lock forward. Borg and Wood in the back row. Matalavia Booth and Tofeano in the front row. Adamson at hooker. On the bench, Moser, Alapaki, Jake Parker, Seth Nicotimo, Lockie West, Logan Lewis and PJ Patazzi. They're coached by Glenn Campbell.
A grand final, you never ever forget your grand finals. They're very hard to make no matter what level you're at. And here's a great cheer squad for the Palm Beach Currumbin boys.
Yes, of course, the coach for Palm Beach Currumbin is Brad Davis, former Palm Beach Currumbin player himself. Brad Davis is the coach of Palm Beach Currumbin. And here they come, Davis's troops, the defending champions. Two old foes in this one going head-to-head in what is the biggest rivalry in Queensland schoolboy rugby league. Palm Beach from the south, founded in 1972. Only 1 year later, Keebra Park in the north in Southport, founded in 1973. And Keebra coach Glenn Campbell said recently that Palm Beach and Keebra is his favourite day of the year, bar none, including Christmas. Well, here they come, the Keebra Park side. running onto the field, led by Captain Trey Penny. Keebra Park and Palm Beach Currumbin going head-to-head here in what is a fairy tale grand final. As we mentioned, the first ever grand final played in the Alan Langer Trophy. And Keebra taking the field here. They will be kicking off with Palm Beach Currumbin receiving.
Stay behind!
For Keebra. And we're underway here in the first ever Alan Langer Trophy grand final. And Dave Talia kicks it out on the full.
He perched that up very high and went for a high kick. Once you hook it like that, you're going to be in danger of going out in the full. That's a big mistake. They're going to take the tap after interference in the play of the ball.
So Palm Beach Currumbin through Willison, the 10. Contracted to the Brisbane Broncos is Willison. Rivet goes short to Cullen. What a dream start this would be for Palm Beach Currumbin. The hooker, Uta Bergen, goes across field through the halves. Rivet, Weaver, and here's Butterini. Butterini is over for Palm Beach Currumbin. Tom Weaver, the halfback, moves in and strikes it. And unsuccessful. Of course, Tom Weaver was named in the Courier Mail Team of the Year at half, as was Ryan Rivet. He's partner in crime there. But it's Palm Beach Currumbin who score first. Let's go down the sideline. Cam Stallard.
Drew, you mentioned it was a dream start for Palm Beach Currumbin. A little bit out of the ordinary as well. I think the winner of this match will be the team that plays for the full 60 minutes. If we have a look at the Alan Langer Trophy season, Keebra Park have had really strong first half but have really had ordinary second halves, whereas Palm Beach have been completely the opposite. Have had a slow start in the opening 30 but have really put the foot down to finish the game.
Well, interestingly, you say that Cam Stallard there on the sideline. Keebra coach Glenn Campbell said during the week on the school footy show, David Wright, that he thinks this game will be won and lost in the ruck. What do you think?
Yeah, well, you've got to control that ruck. You've got to be able to dominate the ruck. I think both sides are very strong in the forwards. I think they'll pretty much nullify each other there. Critical part of the game. Once you get that standoff there, then the backs need to take over. Charge down.
Yes, Weaver's kick was charged down and Keebra come away with it. Leighton Borg it was. So Keebra with some possession finally, and they get a penalty all of a sudden.
So here's Keebra's first good opportunity to go on the attack.
So tap and go, and this is Herman Tofeano. Perhaps a little unlucky not to make that team of the year. And Keebra Park, well, they finished the regular season, Keebra, with the best attack in the competition. More points scored. We know they're capable of scoring tries. Tofeano again. Takani. Here's a backline play again. They're so good at this. Captain Trey Penny responds. And Keebra Parker over.
What a great team try. The coach should be grinning from ear to ear, Glenn Campbell. Beautiful setup play. Both sides have got great back lines that can take advantage of any lapse in the defence. And that line run there by Trey Penny, he might be playing on the right wing, but he's come across here to make an extra man. Have a look at this. That's the right winger running there. So that's beautiful play there. He's taken him off the right wing. They had the penalty. They were able to set up for the play.
The halfback. He's had a stellar season. He moves in and strikes it nicely. Just waved away. So 4-4 the score. As we have a look at the try again here, David Wright and Takani just holding it up nicely. You had Khan Pereira lined up. Jareen Buller. They were all there. It's which one you choose.
Carney, I should say. And he sets up that try beautifully.
And that's a big kickoff from Palm Beach Currumbin. In fact, it's too big. It's gone out on the full. In fact, it's almost gone into the East Leagues Club, David Wright.
It has. The adrenaline is running at a high pitch. They've got young kids here playing in grand finals. They're so keen. Saves the day, but it's a goal on dropout.
Well, what an entertaining start to this one. Opening 10 minutes, of course, we play 30-minute halves at this level. And here's Brock Priestley. Another one who's had an outstanding season in 2020, Uta Bergen from dummy half for Palm Beach Currumbin.
Seven or four! Eight, make line! Hold! Die, two.
Reef Somerville, the centre. Rivet, and here's Xavier Willison, the captain, who is yet to lose to Keebra in his career. Xavier Willison, he's played Keebra for three wins, and a lovely pass out to Troy Duckett, and Palm Beach Currumbin have scored yet again. It's tit for tat here in the grand final, but what a lovely pass.
The defence was just one or two down. Have a look at it. Weaver, he doesn't pass immediately. Takes a couple of paces and then bang, over the top. Could see they were short out there. The pass out there to Duckett, who's scored plenty this year.
Here is the man with that try assist, Weaver, to add the extras. And it is a wonderful kick. So 10 points to 4, Palm Beach Currumbin lead. As we have a look at the replay here, Weaver, and just lovely pass over the top. Cutout pass finds his winger.
Athleticism. He's got a great motor and a good young kid.
Well, it's try for try here in the opening 12 and a half. Palm Beach Currumbin, the defending champions, lead 10-4. 2020 Alan Langer Trophy Grand Final. And here's Willison, Xavier Willison, the captain today, of course. Palm Beach Currumbin's regular captain, Damon Somerville, ruled out with that knee injury, season ending.
That was early in the piece too, I think, so it was might even been first or second game.
And here's Weaver with the dummy. Of course, Palm Beach Currumbin looking for their third title in a row, something Keebra has achieved. And the winner today will be the first to 9 Alan Langer Trophy finals in this 20th edition. The first time we've had a grand final, and there's a high kick on the last, and well taken there at the back by Levi Jones, the competition's leading try scorer.
Making it back 13. Right. When ready.
So Daniel Butterini at the footy will start the set. Here's Xavier Willison.
Nine, now.
He's got some pace for a big man. Signed by the Brisbane Broncos. Here's Cullen. He's been a bit of an unsung hero in 2020 for PBC. Has Jack Cullen represented New South Wales country in under-16s. Reef Somerville now. Another New South Wales under-16 representative as they go. Centre field Rivet out to Weaver. Inside pass here to Butterini. Uta Bergen, Rivet, cut out pass to the winger, and try time, Michael Roberts. In fact, they've called it forward. The pass has been ruled to have gone forward. Have a look at the replay here. There wasn't a lot in it, but probably the right call there.
He was in good position to cover that little grubber kick. Had to come in from his wing a long way in, but they've handed over possession again. Well, you can't keep doing it. He decided to knock it back and they couldn't go on with it. 30 seconds up to half time.
10-4 the score, Palm Beach Currumbin over Keebra Park. Here's Bryant. It's Parker Bryant, wrapped up by Moser and also Alapaki. Here's Martin. Tofeano there in the tackle as well as Gunn James. And they spread it here, Palm Beach Currumbin. Weaver! Oh, we had Jalen DeGroote, the fullback, coming through. And Parker from dummy half as the siren sounds. And Xavier Willison will be wrapped up in what has been a highly entertaining half of football, David.
Well, let's hope we don't repeat that in the second half. Thankfully, we're only one try. One try. Congratulations, we're only one try down. Right, we've got to get back in our grind, fellas. We're giving them too much football. And it's just silly stuff. A couple of out on the falls, penalty down there on the edge, they're getting cut-out passes. They got so much time on the ball. You guys are burning so much petrol by giving them their errors. Right, we're better than this. You don't get to go to grand finals very often, and you're standing here, right, trying to come up with miraculous plays when we don't have to. But we've got the players in the bag when we need to get to our position. We need to be at that end of the football field. And then we set for ourselves, but we've got to do the hard grind. couple of times there I saw the grind coming back. All right, but we're still making fundamental errors that we don't need to. It's not on, a little bit more safety, all right? Field position. All right, very, very important. Mr. Norman?
Hey, boys, we're down by one try and we had a shocker. How good's that? Okay, the defence on the line after those first two tries was amazing. So take heaps of confidence out of that. They don't look like scoring in that last 15 minutes, and we gave them a million chances. On the contrast, when we get down there, our one set where we actually start the ball where we want to do it, we score without being touched. So we're going to score points. We scored 3 tries in 5 minutes against these guys the last time we played them. So points aren't our issue. Let's just make sure that we earn the right to play our sexy moves down that end of the field. And that's by doing the hard work and completing our sets to get up here. Okay? So if it's second tackle and that pass is maybe on, take the hit up, take the tackle. We punch one more and we go off the back of that. Okay? Don't forget when we get to that 40, Tavali, anchor the short side, because that's the easy try. Wherever we can take the easy try, that's the perfect option. Okay? But the main thing that we spoke about is our defence and our composure.
Going for 3 Alan Langer titles in a row. We're underway here in the second half. Ryan Rivett with a short kickoff and Keebra out and about. And Palm Beach Currumbin have come up with it through Brock Priestley. How many times have we seen that today?
Oh, unbelievable. What were Keebra thinking? You've got to take the ball on the full. Great chance for Palm Beach.
Here's Parker Bryant.
Just before the line, fellas. 12, 13. Right, 12,
dummy half. 12. His brother Oscar. And Rivett goes to Willison. And in the tackle, Talia Haas. And also Gunn James, as we've got our first penalty of the second half. So Tom Weaver here to add 2 points to the tally for Palm Beach Currumbin, and he does exactly that.
Greens, I tell you what, the moment that penalty was awarded, I've never seen a trainer run so fast from the Palm Beach Currumbin bench to get the message out for 2 points. Of course, the winner of the Alan Langer Trophy will take on the winner of the Aaron Payne Cup, which was the Kerwin Bears today, getting the win over 38 points to 10 over Ignatius Park. And of course, the two sides, the one that wins today and Kerwin, will take on each other for the Phil Hall Cup next week.
Yes, thank you, Cam. Cam Stella, the community content producer at the QRL. And talking about that match there, that'll be played in Townsville next week. But for now, Alan Langer Trophy titles. Bragging rights on the line. Here's Willison for Palm Beach Currumbin. Of course, the winner today becomes the most successful side in Alan Langer Trophy history, with both these sides having won 8 titles. High kick there on the last by Rivett. Taken by Khan Pereira, and Khan Pereira does well. Now, do they go for the short drop out here, Ryan?
No, I don't think so. I think at 8 points down, you've got to keep punching them down there.
So the drop out, they do go long. And here's Cullen, like a steam train. Legs pumping.
Good post-contact meters too.
Absolutely. Played by Jack Cullen. Here's Oscar Bryant, who finds Bailey Mark. Well, how many times have they been tackled in their opposition 20 today? Palm Beach Currumbin. And there's a hospital pass, if ever you've seen one. And, well, Keebra have somehow managed to hang on yet again. And we have to applaud their defence, David, right? Surely.
That was a fantastic front-on tackle that dislodged possession. And they've done well to strike back straight away. That's what you've got to do. You can't sit back on your heels.
So that was Trey Penny, and now Herman Tofeano, who's back on the field, up to the 40.
Get a lot of confidence from this, Keebra.
Haven't been up this end for a while. Talia shows and goes, wrapped up by Palm Beach Currumbin defence in Butterini. And there's Adamson from hooker. We haven't seen a lot of him yet. Tofeano. Dave Talia, he couldn't hang on to it. And scooped up here by Palm Beach Currumbin. It's Tom Weaver who steps inside, and he's still going as he centres. Eventually tackled by Buller from Keebra Park.
He had some speed men chasing him down because he's no slouch, Weaver.
They go to the right here. Rivett, they've got some numbers here. It's with Reef Somerville. And Somerville's through as he slices through the Keebra defence. And Reef Somerville scores a very important try for Palm Beach Currumbin.
He had about 3 speedmen chasing him, nonetheless, Bueller. And then they moved it straight to the right inside. They knew they had them skinny. And then again, good work there by Reeve Somerville. Held it out in two hands for a couple of moments to decide whether he was going to pass or run.
So Tom Weaver to make it beyond two converted tries. And he misses.
And then they went on the job. They picked the opportunity on that right hand side. Knew they were thin there, as you called to Drury. And they come up with the points.
So long kick off here. And huge shot there on Xavier Willison. Top Ayano along with Gunn James for Keebra Park. So 16-4 the score here. And sideline Cam Stallard, I believe you've got an update for us.
Yeah, after that try was scored, Dave Talia come to the sideline and ripped his strapping off. So Glenn Campbell might have taken the halfback off after that unforced error. So I think his night is done as well, as he ripped the tape off as he made his way to the bench.
So perhaps a reshuffle in the halves for Keebra Park.
Yeah, well, I'll need it, because Talia was one of the better players last week. He hasn't had a dominant game tonight.
So a knock on here, and they'll get a fresh set here. Palm Beach, Currumbin.
Knock on again.
Was the advantage over?
Well, it was a play the ball, so it's got to be over, I'd say. Well, Keebra, two tries they need in 5 minutes. Big ask.
Well, it's now or never, as you just alluded to. Here's the man that's just come on in Lockie West. Haas with it now. Cleese Haas, who is certainly one of their best players in the semi-final victory last week over Wavell.
Now's the time to start throwing it around too. It's all very well to be picking up 10 metres a ruck, but if you've got to get two tries in four minutes, you've got to do more than that.
Matalavia Booth. Close to halfway. There's a penalty, so this will make it interesting. They score here, David Wright, and it's game on.
Yeah, the door's ajar. It's up to Keebra to kick it down. Halfway, fellas.
So quick tap and go, and that's a little bit of urgency now we're starting to see. Jareen Buller. As Adamson playing a bit of first receiver there, it seems. Inside pass to his front row forward. Matalavia Booth, and now here's Tofeano.
Stand there, 14, make it. Go.
Adamson holds it up nicely. They're over. Tyrone Gunn James. And that is just what the doctor ordered for Keebra Park.
But he'd be pretty happy with that. Let's have another look at it. Straight off the dummy half. Good work there by Adamson to take a couple of paces. He's done a Cameron Smith. A couple of little paces out of the dummy half position. He's missed the kick.
Well, that's un-Connor Takani-like. We've been watching him nail it from the sideline all season.
What do you think of? They could have been rushing, knowing they had to get back quickly. Didn't take enough time.
Sideline Cam Stallard.
The crowd just went silent, or half the crowd anyway, when Connor Takani missed that conversion. I understand that sides, you know, time's against you, you've got to rush the kick, but it's got to be a guarantee that you put it over the black dot, and sadly for Keebra Park, it wasn't to be.
Well, Keebra with less than, well, just over a minute and a half remaining, rather, in this one. Here's Haas. Up to the 40. And it remains a two-try game. Matalavia Booth. Huge run from Isaac Matalavia Booth. And yes, wraps to Lachlan Adamson with that last try. Here they go through the hands to Carney. Finds Khan Pereira. Last tackle. They must score here to have any chance, Keebra Park. Through the hands, they get to their kick finally. There'll be a contest here, but taken by Mariner. And it'll be a penalty to Palm Beach, Currumbin.
Yeah, poorly executed last kick there by Keebra. Players were in front of him already. That's just, you know, it's attention to detail makes the difference, especially in the big ones.
And that conversion attempt, just going back to that, I mean, what we've seen from him all season, I mean, he's usually a reliable goal kicker.
Normally spot on. And,
He's been arguably the best goal kicker all 2020 season.
All you can think of is he thought he had to do it within a short period of time to give maximum chance. They've missed their opportunity. You couldn't get an 8-point try now, could we?
Connor Takani has had a stellar season with the boots. Very unlike him, but that's what big games can do. Here's Willison.
Just hang on to the ball, Palm Beach. It's all over. You just take a tap here and walk up and take the tackle.
Well, there's a penalty to Palm Beach, Currumbin.
Tap and walk.
And the siren has gone.
Don't take two, fellas. You don't need two.
As they kick it out. And that's all over. The 2020 Alan Langer Trophy goes to Palm Beach Currumbin, who have become the most successful school in Alan Langer Trophy history with their first three-peat.
But he's like KFC. It must have been.